Electrical circuits. They may seem kind of confusing, and there's a lot of different equations and different units you have to know, but today I'm going to do my best to explain how everything works, as well as show off my circuit calculator, which shows you everything you need to know about a circuit, so that you can also understand the amazing world of electrical circuits. Now, first off, you may be wondering, why did I make a calculator that can calculate different circuits and their effective resistance, and so on? Well, it's because I am learning about this in school myself, and I find it very, very fascinating, so I decided, instead of just memorizing and doing the equations myself, I'm going to instead program a simulator to do it, because if the simulator can do it, then I for sure can do it, since I made the simulator. Having said that, keep in mind that I am still a student, so if I say something wrong, or if I use some wrong terminology, I would appreciate feedback in the comments, but don't send any hate, I'm still learning this myself. With that, let's get right into it. So essentially, what I have made here is a way to build different circuits. You can see I have 5 items, and I'll demonstrate how I build a circuit later. And here we can see we have 2 circuits. They might look the same at first because they have a 9-volt battery. Here we have a 9-volt battery, and here we have 3 resistors, and there we have 3 resistors. But it's actually a different story when we run the simulation. To run it, I just right-click this note block, and it actually runs the entire thing, shows me some stuff in chat, and it also shows everything I need to know. So if you look, the effective resistance is 300. Whereas if I right click this one, we can see the effective resistance is only 33. So I'm gonna explain all the math behind this right now. Here we have the most basic circuit you can have. We have a battery, which is 9 volts, pretty standard, and we have a conductor connecting the battery. The conventional way of thinking about a circuit is you have the positive side and the negative side of the battery. Here the arrow is pointing towards the positive. So it will show the current going from the positive side to the negative side. However, that's not actually what's happening. In fact, what's happening is that this side is the negative side, and this side is the positive side. This side has electrons, which have a potential difference to this side. So they want to get to this side somehow. And when we connect it with a conductor, which lets the electrons pass through, it will travel from this side to that side. So in reality, they got it wrong when they first named this side positive and that side negative. And why have they not changed it? Well, because people are lazy and it was too much work to change the whole system. So now everything's very confusing. You can thank science for that. But the point is, for the course of this video, I will say that things are going from the positive to the negative side, but just keep in mind that's not actually what's happening. Well, you may think, well, that's about it. It just sends the charge through the wire and it gets to the other side and that's it. Well, that's not true. There's actually a lot more happening. And to do that, I'm going to introduce you to 5 special units, which you should know. The first unit is a coulomb, and simply speaking, the coulomb is the measure of electrical charge. The thing I am sending through the circuit right now is an electrical charge, and for now, we can assume that this little green square is 1 coulomb. It's just a measure of how much charge that thing is holding. To be specific, 1 coulomb is 6,241,409,074,460,762,607.776 elementary charges. So an elementary charge would be 1 electron or 1 proton. So you can see that 1 coulomb is a lot of electrons. The second unit is the amp. 1 amp is 1 coulomb per second. So an amp is the measure of current. How many of these charges are going through per second? The third unit you need to know is the volt. Now here you can see this battery is 9.0 volts, but what does that actually mean? Well, that is actually showing how many joules or how much energy it is pushing each coulomb with. So 9 volts is actually pushing each coulomb of charge with 9 joules of energy. So that is showing how strong it can push each coulomb with. So the higher the voltage, the stronger each coulomb is being pushed, and the lower this voltage, the weaker it's pushing everything. So this is an important factor which defines how powerful or how dangerous the circuit is. The fourth unit you need to know is the watt. Now the watt is a unit of power. This is different from voltage because the watt is voltage times the current. If you have a 9-volt battery, but there is no current, there are no watts because it's not doing anything, there's no power. You need current to have power as well. You can have a very weak battery and a lot of current and still be very powerful. Or you can have a very, 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 very strong battery but have no current and be very weak. And last but not least is the ohm. This is a measure of resistance. If I add a resistance here, you can see it has that omega symbol. That is representing ohms. So we can put this to 100 ohms. Now, what exactly is the ohm? Well, there's actually a lot of different ways to define it and a lot of equations. For the time being, you don't have to worry about what defines it. Just know that the higher this number, the lower the current will be. For the highest current, we want the least amount of resistance. Now that you understand all 5 of those units, I can start explaining what all these calculations even mean. mean? When we run this simulation, it's very simple. We have some voltage and we have only one resistor in the entire circuit. So we know the resistance of the whole circuit will be only 100 ohms. And if we check the calculations, we can see the effective resistance of the whole circuit is only 100 ohms, which is what we expect. The voltage is 9.0 volts, which is what we have in the battery. The current is 0.09 amps. The power is 0.81 watts. And if this is all we had to do to calculate this kind of stuff, I wouldn't need to make any of this calculator and you could just do it by yourself. But the problem is that you don't usually only have one resistor in a circuit like this. So if we go back to my original two circuits here, you can see that again, it's the same setup. We've got 9-volt battery there, 9-volt battery here, and again, three of the same resistors, but just lined up slightly differently. And this actually is very important because if I run this one, you can see that it has an effective resistance of 300, but if I run this one, it has an effective resistance of 33. So what's the difference? Why would this one have a lot more resistance than this one if we have the same amount of resistors? Well, I'm glad you asked. The difference between these two circuits is that this one is a series circuit and this one is a parallel circuit. The best way to visualize this is just to follow the path of the charge. The charge will leave the battery, make a turn, travel through this resistor, then turn and travel through this resistor, and finally travel through this resistor as well before returning to the battery. And because the charge is forced to go through each individual resistor, this would be a series circuit. And we can calculate the effective resistance with the equation effective resistance equals A plus B plus C, and so on. So in this case, it would be effective resistance equals 100 plus 100 plus 100, which in total is 300, which is exactly what we get if we run this simulation. You can see it says 300. However, if we follow the charge of this circuit, it will leave the battery, make a turn, but then it has a choice. It can either go through this resistor or continue on, go through this resistor or continue on and go through this resistor. So it can go through each individual resistor and it's not forced to go through any one of these. And when it has a choice like this to go through multiple resistors, this is called a parallel circuit. And to calculate the effective resistance of this kind of circuit would be 1 over effective resistance equals 1 over A plus 1 over B plus 1 over C. So you can see it's set up slightly differently. And the result of that is that the effective resistance is actually less than each individual resistor. Now, that's also not the end of the story. Unfortunately, things get a bit more complicated than that. And I'll demonstrate this just by building a simple circuit. Now, I showed you these circuits and you can easily build a circuit with my data pack using these five items. Let's start with a battery. Here we have a battery. I can stand on it to change the value just by scrolling. So right now I'm changing the decimal place, but if I sneak, you can see above my hotbar, it's changing what value I'm changing this by. So let's change it to 1 and make it exactly 9 volts. Then using the conductor, I can actually place it down. This is just what the electron will travel on. And using this input, I can make a corner. So now if I right click this, the electron will travel through the corner. I can place down a resistor here. And again, using the scrolling thing, I can set it to like 100 and then just make it 100 like so. So now the electron will have to go through that resistor over there. Another thing the input can do is actually split the current. So if I put an input right there and put two lines going out like that, you can see that the charge actually goes through both of them. So that's what we can use to set up a parallel circuit. And once you have a parallel circuit like this, where the electron can go this way, it will all go into an output, so it all goes in the same direction. And I'll explain later on why we need this instead of an input. Now that I've finished my circuit, all I have to do is right click the battery and it will run the entire simulation for me. So you can see that it says the overview in chat, specifically 425 total resistance, and you can see that is less than all these combined because we clearly have some sort of parallel circuit going on. And here's where things get complicated. You may be tempted to say, well, this is just a parallel circuit. Right here, it splits. It can either go this way or it can go that way. So let's just add everything up by doing 1 over A plus 1 over B plus 1 over C and so on. But that's not true. For example, when it goes through here and it reaches this spot, yeah, it can go this way or it can go that way. So these two combined would be a parallel circuit. But these two individual resistors right here, it is not a parallel circuit. When it goes this direction, it has to go through both of them. It does not have a choice. So this right here is a series circuit. Same goes for this stretch. It has to go through this one, and then it has to go through this one, and then it has to go through this one. So this all is also a series circuit. So we have a series circuit and a series circuit that are combined into a parallel circuit. And then that is also added onto another series circuit. So once you have a lot of series circuits and parallel circuits combined, things get very complicated with the equation. In fact, to calculate this all in one equation, the equation would look something like this. So obviously that would take a lot of math to do. What my simulator does is it does that all for you. If I run this simulation, it will do everything for me and it gives me everything I need to know. Now, in the end, this is all Minecraft, meaning there are a lot of limitations. The biggest challenge is that Minecraft does not have decimals. If I want to set a score for myself, I can set it to something like 1000, but I cannot set it to 1000.1. It only allows whole numbers. It does not allow any decimal, which means that all of these numbers here, 100.0, this is actually being stored as 1000. 9.0 is actually being stored as 90. And that is why if we run the simulation, and you can see it says each resistor in chat, it says 1000 instead of 100. And this method gives me that extra decimal place, and it works fine as long as I'm doing addition, subtraction, or multiplication. But of course, when it comes to division, there's usually always a lot of decimal places afterwards. But obviously, since Minecraft cannot hold decimal places, it instead has to round the number after each division. And for a small circuit like this, where we're only dealing with mainly one operation, which is this one parallel circuit, it's relatively close. It will have very minor error. But for something more complicated like this, or something like that, which I'll show you in a second, the error will become larger and larger for each division that it's doing. So that is something to keep in mind, since this is Minecraft, that is a limitation. Then to display it here, I just go through a series of operations to first get the three first numbers and then the last digit and combine it with a decimal place. But in reality, this is just 1000. Now, one last important thing which I need to explain is this output, as I'm calling it, which I had before. Now, normally in a circuit, you wouldn't need this. You could have an input, because when the electron leaves, it will always go to the place where it has the biggest potential difference. So in this case, the charge wants to go from this side to this side. So when it would go through here and it would turn, it would only go this way because that's the potential difference. It would never turn back. But in this case, since this is Minecraft, this is a simulation, it doesn't actually know which way has the biggest potential difference. So if I were to run this as it is, it would get stuck in a loop, because it's going this way and then coming back and going this way. Yeah, some of it goes there, but it keeps going back in a loop. So the only workaround for this is to actually put in an output, as I'm calling it, which only lets the charge go in one direction. So I've put an output here now. The charge will go into this output from this side, go that way, and this side, it will also only go that way. So that keeps it from going in a perpetual loop. So now you can see, it all goes nicely, calculates everything for us. But keep in mind that in real life, this you would not need this. The charge would by itself go to the place of biggest potential difference, which is this side of the battery. All that to say that my data pack can actually allow you to build very, very complicated circuits like this one right here, and it will calculate everything you need to know for you. You can see the charge goes through everything, calculates everything, and in the end, you can see my total resistance was 306. And that is significantly less than all of these combined, because you can see there's a lot of parallel circuits going on here. We have a parallel circuit right here, a parallel circuit right there. Here's a parallel one, there's a parallel one, there's another parallel one down here, and there. So there's a lot of parallels that need to be combined with each other. And again, the equation to do this by hand would be very, very, very long, but this can do it all for you with some error, of course, but it can give you a really good estimate of that. So let me know if you have any questions down below, and I hope you enjoyed this circuit. It took me a while to make, but it was very fun. And with that, I hope to see you in the next video.